We have to leave that in. We have to leave it. Welcome back to the Gemini Archives. That was unplanned. I literally opened my mouth to say something and that happened.
Like, we filmed a different, like, we got 1 minute in and I realized, like, oh, hold on, I need to text everyone in our house, like, hey, don't fucking bother us, we're doing a podcast. And we had a whole different intro, and then we came back and Megan just fucking burps. I'm so sorry. I just drank like a fuck ton of water. We're going through a heat wave right now.
Ugh, don't even get me fucking started on this heat wave.
This heat wave has been disgusting. But welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to the Gemini Archives. I don't know if we said
that. But sorry about that. It's not very ladylike at all. Although I look like a lady right now. I mean, I always look like a lady.
Yeah.
That's super me to say.
More like a lady. Because I'm wearing like a nice like lace thing over me. I look like a middle-aged housewife who's having a crisis. And she's like sitting there at 3 a.m. with her arms crossed. And she's like, I don't know if I could do this anymore. That's what I look like right now.
Uh-huh.
But,
so, yeah, we're going through a heat wave. So if you hear a little extra background noise, it's so hot in this house
that
I have the air blasting, a fan going, because where our rooms are, they're upstairs, and the walls aren't, like, properly, like, insulated, so it gets, like, literally 20 degrees hotter than the rest of the house.
Well, and especially in my room, because I get all the sun during the day on my side of the house. So it's fun. It's a fun time. I have been dying.
It's been 95 with humidity for 4 days straight.
And, well, the first day, it felt like 112.
Yeah.
I'm so glad that at least we have air conditioning downstairs, because I was like worried about our cats.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I hope they're okay. But they were totally fine. Even like yesterday. Yesterday was the 4th of July.
Yeah.
Terminator timeline. And they just slept through all the fireworks and all the noise. Like, they're so unbothered by things.
They don't give a shit.
That's why I love cats. Because they're just so unbothered. But we have been melting. I think I said it to someone. I'm like, if you don't hear from me for a while, it's because I have been reduced to nothing but a hat and a broom.
You texted that to me.
Oh, that was you.
Yeah.
It's like, that's what happened, and I have officially melted, and remember me fondly.
Yeah. Like, literally, I have all my lights off in my room right now, and a fan going, and the AC, like, on full blast. And, like, it's cool enough in here, but like it probably in about like 20 minutes gonna get hot as hell.
Yeah, usually we're doing this in the morning. Usually we do it in like the afternoon.
Yeah.
Oh, excuse me, I almost burped again. But we decided to do it in the morning before it got too hot.
What? I would have lost it if you burped again.
I'm sorry. Drank like a fuck ton of water because we've been trying to like keep ourselves hydrated.
God, I have been pissing every 30 minutes. Like, on the dot. I'm just like, ugh.
I know, and then we gotta, like, replenish everything we just pissed out.
Yeah, because like, I'm already sweating. I'm like, Jesus Christ.
I know, it sucks. And I'm so annoyed because, like, we were supposed to go get our hair done today.
Yeah, and then our hairdresser texts us, and she's like, yeah, the AC broke in our place. Let's put you in for next week. I'm like, son of a bitch.
I'm like, At first I was like, oh, great. Now I got to wait a week to get my hair done. But then I'm like, you know what? I am not toughing it out in this heat today.
For those of you that don't know, Megan and I are very warm-blooded people.
Yes.
If we sit next to each other, like the way we sit for the podcast, there's some space between us. Thank merciful God.
Yeah.
Because otherwise you would just see steam rise. Like,
you would hear it in the mic. It would just sound like fire.
Yeah. We cannot sit next to each other or just anyone in general.
What? Hand me that.
Oh.
I gotta make a mental note.
Okay. Because my God, it's just like we will burst into flame. Because we get it from our dad, because our dad is the same exact... Hi, Dad. Is the same way. Like, he'll stand next to me for all 3 seconds. I'm like, I'm already sweating.
Yeah. It's true. I remember one time we had to go to, like, some, like, mass thing for our family. And it was me, Lauren, my dad, and my aunt, who is just like us, you know, warm as hell all the time. And I swear to God, literal steam was rising up in the church because of it.
Ridiculous.
And like we had to, because the
seats were really close together, and I'm like, okay, we have to spread out.
Yeah.
Because we are making this place 20 degrees hotter just by sitting next to each other.
You could literally see the steam coming off of us.
No.
We were so warm.
And, like, the first one to break, like, a bead of sweat was the winner.
I know.
But, yeah.
It was my dad who just sweats sitting and doing nothing.
Yeah.
Literally. Not because he's overweight, but just he's so warm-blooded.
So, we inherited that. So, like, this week has been hell on earth for us, literally.
Oh, my gosh. I feel like my body's on fire. And, like, this morning, though, finally, I'm like, God, I'm cold. I'm like,
I know. Yes. I literally put on sleeves today.
I know. I didn't, because I'm like, I'm going to embrace the cold for a little bit, because I've been hot as fuck for 4 days.
I know, right?
Jesus Christ.
But, like, even yesterday was the 4th, it was like, we went outside, we, you know, for a little while, we were lighting sparklers and hanging out and stuff, and it was just like, we couldn't even stay out for that long because I couldn't breathe.
I know, it was way too hot, and it was like 7 o'clock, and it was like 80-something degrees, but it was like literally 200% humidity, so it felt like 100 degrees at 8 o'clock. I'm like, God damn it.
I know, oh,
because
it was so bad.
Because where we live, we're landlocked in the middle of the state. So, it's 10 degrees hotter than anywhere else near the shore or whatever.
Ugh.
It's fucking garbage.
It was, like, just a wet heat.
Yeah.
It was so gross. It was literally hell. So, we have been dying this week, and we're hoping, like, tomorrow it's supposed to break finally.
How the fucking Luya?
And I'm just like, I just need cold in my life again. I miss the cold. And I literally said a couple days ago, I'm like, I want to find the glacier that sunk the Titanic and make a house out of it.
Honestly.
Because that's where I am right now in my life.
I would love nothing more than to live in a glacier right now.
Yes.
Just naked.
Yes.
Yeah. Or stay in like one of those like ice hotels.
Ugh.
You ever seen that?
Yes.
It looks cool, but I'm like, I don't know if I would like that.
I think it would just be, because it's like, how do you get dressed?
I know. How do you take a shower and, like, use the bathroom?
I know.
I'd be too cold. But I would sleep great.
Yes.
I cannot sleep unless it's, like, super cold in my room.
Yes. It would be so nice.
Yeah.
That would be, like, the deepest sleep I'd ever have in my life.
Oh, my God. And if it was, because it's in the middle of the woods, so it'd be quiet.
Yeah.
God help me.
Because the only times I've ever really slept well is, like, when I'm in, like, places that have like central air.
Yeah.
Like, so like hotels or like houses with central air, I sleep like a fucking rock.
Yeah. Or if we're near water. Like we're near like at a beach house or like taking on a vacation.
We took on a vacation.
We
once.
Took it on. We're taking a vacation.
Yes.
God help me.
Yeah, I know. It's true. And it's like living here fucking sucks.
Yeah.
And I'm so annoyed because Lauren put on a full face of makeup and I look like an actual gremlin.
Well, I thought we were going.
Yeah.
So I got up and just put my face on.
And Lauren, the highlight is like blinding me right now.
I'm sorry. Should I turn a little or?
No, it's great.
Okay.
I'm just like a...
Like, word of advice to any girls listening to this podcast that wear like decent amount of makeup. If you have to be out of the house in 10 minutes, just put on a fuck ton of highlight.
Yeah.
It drowns everything else out.
Yeah.
In like a good lipstick and mascara. That's all you need.
Yes.
And maybe a little contour if you don't want to look like a fucking potato head.
Me.
My head is so round. It's so round.
It's not that round, Lauren.
Like, I swear to God. It's perfectly circular. Like a basketball.
Wait, look at me. You are not circular.
I am too.
You got cheekbones. And jawbones.
Jawbones that are hidden by circular fat.
Lauren.
They are.
Stop.
Look at... Anyone look at a picture of me and tell me my head isn't round as fuck.
Lauren.
It looks like those little circles above the lyrics for kids' songs that bounce to the words.
Like the Disney sing-along?
Yeah. I look like the Mickey Mouse head bouncing on top of the lyrics at the bottom of the screen.
Stop it. Jesus Christ.
This heat is making me delirious. So if I'm more chatty than usual, I'm so sorry.
You have no idea how tired I am right now.
I know, I'm exhausted.
I'm incredibly tired.
Ugh.
Just because I haven't slept well in like almost a week because of this fucking heat.
I know. Plus you had like an ear
problem. My ear has been bothering me and fucking everything else aches. I'm just like fucking, I'm a mess. I know. It's like, somebody please put me out of my misery. No, but we're good. But
yeah.
I was so tired last night. I posted this on Facebook, my personal Facebook. I said, and I had no recollection of posting this either.
Yeah.
But I woke up and I saw the post and I just laughed. I'm like, what is up with 2 a.m. Megan? Because one, well, before even that, I bought a lipstick.
Uh-huh.
That I've been wanting for like months that was finally back in stock. And I'm like, I didn't need the lipstick. But I justified it because it was $4 cheaper. And I said, fuck it. But then I made this post. Hold on. What did it... I gotta grab my phone because I don't want to...
Something about like witches and...
Wait, hold on. Wait, I got it. Hold on.
This is so unprofessional.
It's right here. It is right here. I swear it is right in front of my face. Okay, I got it. I said, so how come female witches are called witches, but male witches aren't called mitches?
I don't know, Meg. Why is that?
Ask 2 a.m. Megan. I literally couldn't even tell you.
I couldn't even tell you either. Like, to be fair, I can't even tell you the dumb crap that I've posted on my Facebook before.
Oh my god. So. You post some silly ass shit.
You're telling me.
I still have a post. I don't remember exactly what you said, but something about like, oh yeah, I'm better than Twinkies because I have less trans fats or something.
Yeah. I forgot what that post was.
I forgot too, but the line was, yeah, but I'm better than Twinkies because I have less trans fats.
Yeah, I did say that. How do you measure how much trans fat is in a human? I don't even know.
BMI?
No, I probably have way more trans fat than a Twinkie, honestly.
Same. Oh, man. So we're a little silly today.
God. That, and I've been listening to Radio Bam for, like, 3 days straight.
Oh, well, because, you
and
know.
I feel like all I'm talking is, like, I feel like I'm from Philly now. Oh, or God. From the Pennsylvania area, because I've been listening to him talk for 3 days straight.
You're picking up on their vernacular.
Yeah.
I know.
God, Novak is a dirty human being.
Of course he... Well, he used to be. Now he's not.
God, he had, like, every kind of hepatitis and, like, I'm like, Jesus.
How every did he itis.
Every itis. Probably, like, SARS and, like...
Ew.
Fucking gangrene. I don't know what he had.
Oh, God. That's horrible.
I know. He didn't have that.
Yeah, I know.
But...
I know. It's funny because, you know, we talked last week about, you know, I got Lauren that video from Bam Margera. Yeah. So
we fell down a hole.
Well, you fell down the hole.
Oh, yeah. Here I go again down my hole. It's just put, like, a falling down a hole effect.
I don't even know what that would sound like.
Like the fucking Roadrunner and Coyote where he falls off the cliff.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? And yeah. He just, like, he's going over the edge and it's just, like, that long whistle followed by a... You know? Because he fell.
I hope you're happy. You're just giving me more work to do.
You fucking love it.
Sometimes.
It adds to the show. One day we'll get a soundboard and one day. Won't have to do this.
But
we'll just figure it
out. I won't have to put things in manually. It's a labor of love.
Yes. Anyway, so I've been listening to Radio Bam for like 3 days. And I'm just like, Jesus Christ. Why am I invested?
I know, because what year...
It started in 2004?
That was like a lifetime ago.
And then it ended in 2013. So it's been off the air for a few years now.
Are you going to listen to the whole show?
Yeah, some guy uploaded all of them to YouTube.
How many episodes is it?
Almost like 300. Like for once a week for 10 years.
That's ridiculous.
I know. But I feel like there should be more than that.
Maybe there's some of them they couldn't upload.
Maybe.
That's a lot. Although, I did kill all the bonfire episodes in, like, a few months.
Well, there you go. But,
look, I love the bonfire, okay?
I know. They're great. I'm going to go back to listening to that once I finish this.
Same.
Okay, now I have to strip. You want me to turn my fan?
No.
Hold on. I'm going to turn my fan.
No, it's... Oh, turn it the other way.
Yeah, hold on.
Here's Lauren across the room.
Hey.
Oh, God. Now I'm going to be cold again.
There we go.
I'm going to do this. I'm going to wrap around me like a blanket.
Okay.
Just
to keep the room cool.
Yes. Oh, it's nice. I know.
Holy moly.
So we're generally just hot people.
Yes.
Like, even, like, look-wise, maybe.
I
think I'm a solid 6. You know? Like, I've come to that conclusion.
I think of, like, I would give myself a little bit higher than that. I'd say at least, like, a 7.5.
I can work on my body more, and I can put it to a 7.
Lauren, I would say you're at least an 8.
Stop it.
Yeah. At least.
Megan, now you're just kissing ass.
I'm not kissing. I'm serious. Because you don't see yourself the way other people see you.
I know, that's true. I see myself as round. Round head, round body.
As a Disney sing-along note.
Yeah. You guys know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Where they put the lyrics at the bottom of the screen and it's just Mickey bouncing so you don't lose your place.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, man. So silly.
You ever remember those Disney sing-along VHSs that we had?
You mean the ones that we watched every day consecutively for like 6 years?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do remember those.
Those were like weird. There was like a camping one and then one at like Disney World. Or was it Disneyland? I think it was Disneyland.
I don't know. No, Disney World. And then there was one with, like, Dalmatians, the 101 Dalmatians.
That one was fucking weird.
It was weird.
It was just, like, a lady with glasses that had, like, 8 dogs.
8 Dalmatians. And yeah. She wore Dalmatian print, and her whole house was covered in Dalmatians.
Yeah.
So fucking crazy. I mean, you know what, though? I love Dalmatians.
I know, they are very cute.
They are so adorable. An underrated dog, if I do say.
Like, the tater tot is an underrated potato. Man, I could fuck up a 5-pound bag of tater tots and not even think twice.
I'm so hungry right now.
Sorry.
I'm starving. Because I woke up for this stupid appointment and I didn't eat. I was like, fuck it, we're just recording a podcast today.
I know. We have to cancel our appointment. Our day's all thrown off because we were going to do this in a couple days. But we're like, no, let's just do it. Because we pre-record these in advance and then upload on Mondays.
Yes.
But, yeah, it's just fucking...
We're all over
thrown
the place.
Off.
Yeah.
Fuck this.
But we have a funny episode for today.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be funny.
Oh my gosh. So here we go.
Here we go again with digging back into the, like, call the Gemini archives for a reason. We're going back in the archives. Lauren found, or you didn't find, you went on.
No, just out of like sheer curiosity the other day, I logged into my old Vampire Freaks profile.
Jesus.
And for anyone who doesn't know what Vampire Freaks is, it's basically the goth MySpace.
Yeah.
It's like a whole bunch of goth and like metalheads and just like people of that culture, you know, if you want to call it that.
Yes.
On that website, and you could just like add people and talk to them and blah blah blah. And we used to go on there all the time in high school and like beginning of college, so like we kind of stopped going on there in like 2011, 2012.
Yeah.
And I still have my old profile when I was like 20. I'm 26 now. And I was reading through it and I was cringing so hard. This is only 6 years ago. And yeah. I was like cringing bad.
Oh, so bad.
So like it made me think, I wonder if we saved any others. And Jesus Christ, did we?
I have, Lauren's going to read two. I have one. It's a little bit long. It could count as two.
Yeah. I mean, my one on my VIP profile is so long. I'm like, I don't know how people even read this. But
I know, who found the time?
I know. Like, why am I putting my soul out there for that many people? And then I found a paragraph one that I written when I was 16. So I'm going to read that too.
Oh my God. And so I read one line of mine and I'm like, I want to immolate myself from the planet.
I know. It's like, I want to die right now.
I hate this. Because, well, mine is from when I was a senior in high school.
Yeah. I was a junior in high school.
Yeah. So 2010.
Yeah.
That was 8 years ago.
Or maybe I was a senior, but I wasn't 17 yet.
What year was it?
Because remember, I saved it in 2010. It was probably before my birthday.
Oh, God.
So, I was still in high school.
Ugh. Fuck that.
Jesus Christ.
Fuck that shit. So,
can't.
We are going to read those at the risk of embarrassing ourselves to no end.
Oh, my gosh. I can't.
God
I can't.
Almighty.
Like, I can't believe I'm doing this, but here we're going to do it.
We're doing it.
So, enjoy my cringiness, because I literally thought it was so cool putting that out to the world, like, hey, look at me, you know?
Yeah. It's like, look at how intellectual I am, because I wrote
something
long.
Yeah, that was like a big thing, wasn't it? Like, yeah. You and I were like, big into like saying, oh, we're intelligent people, so have an intelligent conversation with us. Like, you'll hear it. Like, I'll read it.
I'm like, no wonder why I didn't have any friends.
I know, I was awful.
I was the worst. It's horrible.
To be fair, we had terrible influences in our life at the time, so it kind of just...
No one was telling me that this was not okay.
Okay? It's like, bad.
Nobody was telling me, like, Megan, you're an asshole. No one was saying that to me. I know, thought me it was either. Fine. And I had to learn for myself. And I'm like, oof, I probably shouldn't talk like that.
And we kept attracting the wrong people.
Well, that's what happens.
Hence every fucking douchebag I've ever dated in my life. Hmm. Someone want to send me a good guy, please?
Press just, 1 to send Lauren a good man.
Put him in a box. Just leave him on the doorstep.
It's like, I'll take good care of him.
I know, it's hot out there. I'll bring him inside and give him some water.
I'll feed him and care for him and pet him.
Yeah.
Like a little cat. He's like on the floor with the cats.
The cats are just like both huddled together. Like, who the fuck is this?
They're like, what the fuck?
Anyway, well, we're going to go to a break.
We're going to go to a break.
And then we'll come back and read all this fucking shit.
Yep. And I'll put in a little clip of a demo that I was listening to this morning to help myself wake the fuck up.
Yeah.
It's from my buddy, one a band that's not together anymore, but my buddy Sean was in this band called Implosion Crusade. They're pretty damn good.
Yeah.
Pretty loud and in your face type shit. So, and that's what I needed this morning because I was dragging ass.
Yeah.
And I don't know what song I'm gonna put. I'll put in the whole fucking demo. I don't give a shit. Listen to this fucking thing.
No. Go and support it and get it yourself.
Yes. Go buy one.
We're just gonna give you like a taste.
Yeah, I know. Even though they're not together anymore.
Yeah.
And I don't think they're getting back together anytime soon. I don't know. Don't quote me on that. Don't come for me, Sean. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'll put in a little clip here of Implosion Crusade. So you could wake the fuck up with me because yeah. I am exhausted. I'm probably going to fucking jog or something during a break. No, I won't because it's too hot.
No, you're going to melt.
I will melt. I can't drink caffeine anymore, so I don't know how I'm gonna... Like, punch me in the face. I don't know.
You could just put your head in cold water or, like, the freezer.
Oh, I could do that. Just submerge my head in the sink.
Yeah, or do some kind of, like, mild jazzercise. So it's not, like, making you too hot.
Mild. Just, like, finger exercises.
Yeah, there you go. Or just stretching. Stretching is great.
I'll do sun salutations for 20 minutes. Anyone else do yoga? Could you imagine me just like, it's like SpongeBob with the photosynthesis. Oh my god, I'm gonna ruin Lauren's makeup. Not that it fucking matters.
No, it's already ruined. Oh my god, I'm actually crying.
Just me standing there losing my mind doing sun salutations for 20 minutes.
Oh my god.
Holy fuck.
Let's go to break.
Okay, we'll be right back.
Oh!
Welcome back, everyone.
Welcome back.
We had to take a serious break
we had to collect ourselves. Laura couldn't stop laughing.
I could not. Like, you heard me just now. Like, I was dying laughing.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. I'm fine now. I had to get my shit together. And then as I'm taking a drink of water, Megan starts talking, and it almost comes out of my nose.
I'm so sorry. I wasn't even saying anything funny.
It's just the thought of you doing, like, 25,000 sun salutations.
Just, like, I would
one look, after the other.
I would look up, like, a piece of grass waving in the wind.
Yeah.
Or, like, one of those, like, inflatable things outside of car dealerships.
So, I'm gonna start laughing all
I'm
over
sorry.
Again.
Okay. I'm sorry. We're good. We're calm. We're collected. Right. We're cool.
If, oh my gosh, I'm gonna cry laugh at whatever profile you're about to read. I have two, so do you want me to go first, then you, and
yes.
I'll finish? I'll do my short one first. This was from when I was 16 going on 17, like the song,
"You are 16 going on 17.
Insert song here.
Son of a bitch.
It's okay. Baby, listen, it's the Sound of Music is a timeless classic. You better put that shit in. Please.
There were Nazis in there.
It's still a classic.
Please
classic
read your profile.
Nazis. Okay.
Classic Nazis.
All right. This is from when I was 16 going on 17. Ahem. I think this was from MySpace. I'm pretty sure.
God help me.
And the only reason I know I'm 16 is because I said it in the fucking thing. You'll hear it. Here we go. Oh, my God. My name is Lauren, and I like change.
You like change?
The first thing I said.
No, you don't. Well, maybe.
I'm 16 and trying to live life to the fullest. I mean, there's a lot to know about me, really. Like, anyone gives a shit.
What depth do you have at 16?
I don't know.
Well, we'll find out.
Trying to be in, like, as depth as possible.
Yeah.
Like, I live for metal music and shows. Also, I write a lot.
We've been to, like, 6 shows at that point.
I've only been to a few shows.
Yeah.
I went to many more after this.
Well, yeah.
Sorry, my throat was all fucked because I was laughing
so
hard.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Someday, I'm determined to become a journalist or an author or possibly both. That's true. I was going to go to college for journalism, but then I dropped out after a year of that.
Yeah, because fuck that.
And I went for business because I try to be practical. And then I have 2 business degrees I have nothing with. So
great.
I read a lot of different kinds of books. I wish I worked at Borders or Barnes and Noble so I could just be around them.
How about a fucking library? Well,
I mean,
first of all, rip to Borders and Barnes and Noble that
I
don't
know.
Exist anymore.
Well, Barnes and Noble still does, but Borders is fucking gone.
Bye.
Like,
I know.
To be fair, I went to Borders all the time.
Oh yeah, we would hang out in there and read.
And like, I just like the smell of coffee, but I'm like, libraries have that. I could have worked at a library.
Could have. You still can.
I mean, I still could.
Yeah.
At least libraries are quiet.
Yeah. True.
God, that would be such a great job, actually.
I know. It would be.
I know. Call me a dork for saying that, but I seriously love to read that much.
You do. Well, we always have. That's not that bad.
I know. I want to get the hell out of here and go live in Boston someday. I love it there.
Boston?
Why Boston? Why did I say
you
that?
You've been to Boston, like, one time. Twice.
I think we went, like, the year before, and I, like, fucking loved it and wanted to move there. I'm like, I would never live in Boston now.
Yeah.
I would rather live in Alaska before Boston.
I mean, same.
I can honestly say I'm well aware of who my true friends are, and I thank them dearly for being in my life. I don't talk to any of those fucking people anymore.
Ha!
That's so funny. They're the only people who could put up with me, and I wouldn't trade them for anything.
Well, look at the wording there. Put up with me. So you were self-aware even then of how annoying that you were.
I know. It was terrible.
Mean, not to say I was annoying, too, but we both collectively just annoying as fuck.
Oh, totally. And I probably annoyed the shit out of them. Like,
yeah.
All the time.
Probably.
I'm usually a very happy person. I don't let things upset me anymore because it's pointless to waste my time on something that is only going to make me more upset. I mean, that's true, but
yeah,
not really like happy-go-lucky all the time.
Yeah.
Depression sucks.
Yeah.
You know? Depressed people get happy, but we also have our days.
Yep.
So. I would never judge someone by how they look, but by only how they act. And that's the biggest load of shit I've ever said. Are you fucking kidding me?
Everyone
judges that? People for the way they look.
Yeah.
Nah, I mean, not like be an asshole about
well,
it.
Well, not just solely on their looks, but
I'm sorry, but if I see a fucking uppity bitch in a sweater being an asshole to a manager at a restaurant, I'm fucking judging.
Yeah.
Don't even tell me you wouldn't judge that.
Well, I mean, we all kind of judge in our own way.
Well, exactly. Like, I mean, I wouldn't do that to, like, you know. You know what I mean.
Yeah.
Because it's like a first impression type of a thing.
Yeah.
People usually go off looks, and if I actually talked to that woman, maybe she was a good person, but we all judge people on their looks.
Yeah.
Anyone who says they don't is full of shit.
Yeah, it's human nature.
Yeah.
It's what we do.
I like people who could keep a conversation going and don't always say the same thing. That's still true.
Yeah.
I can't stand people who don't talk. They keep life interesting. I really hate stuck up people, so if you're like that in any way, don't expect me to respect you. I mean, true, but why did I have to put that out
there? I know, it's like,
Isn't that just a given?
Yeah.
Common knowledge?
Yeah.
Fucking 16-year-old Lauren. I have OCD, from which I developed at a young age. I really hate how everyone thinks they're such an individual now, even though you're not. Okay, there's so much wrong with those two sentences. First of all, I don't have OCD. I just... Or... What would you say it is? Because, like, I do things sometimes thinking, like, oh, if I do this, this is gonna happen. But it's not really, like...
That's OCD, Lauren.
Well, yeah, but it's not...
It doesn't run your life.
Yeah, it doesn't cripple me, but sometimes, like, if I really want something to happen, I'll do the same thing all the time. So maybe it's, like, a mild form.
Yeah.
But I never got, like, diagnosed. I don't know why I would say I have OCD. I have OCD tendencies.
Yes.
So, even from that age, I did. That's bad.
Yeah, I know.
It was worse when I was younger. I don't really do that shit anymore.
Yeah.
Where the fuck was I?
OCD.
Oh, I really hate how everyone thinks they're such an individual now, even though you're not. That's true.
I mean, honestly, though, that's the thing, right?
Yeah.
With people now, it's like... Oh, look at how I'm such a, like, the special snowflake thing. Look at how special, but it's like, there's nothing special about you.
I know.
You know?
Acting like you're hot shit doesn't make you special, darling. Why would I say that?
Darling.
Darling. Jesus Christ. I'm always paranoid about what's around me. It's a habit I seriously want to break. I overthink things too much and take things way too personally.
What is this, a therapy session?
Why am I bearing my soul like this to, like, the world?
You are too young to be having those thoughts.
I know. And first of all, I don't take shit too personally. I don't know why I would say that. And second of all, what was the other thing I said? I overthink things? Not anymore. Maybe as a fucking teenager, sure, but yeah. I don't do that anymore.
Yep.
My God.
I know.
I've been single for a while now, but that might change soon. As if I just am going to buy a boyfriend soon. So I'm going to change
that. It's like buying, like, a house. Like, oh, I should probably buy that.
Yeah. This is probably in 2009. And I fucking edited this shit because I think I wrote this before I started going out with, like, my long-term relationship with my high school boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
So. Lastly, please don't add or talk to me if you're not interested in getting to know me. It's really annoying how many people add me only because I'm hot to them. Or whatever. If you're going to talk to me, make it interesting, please. I was such an asshole.
Wow, that's very conceited.
Yeah.
Wow.
I know. I was conceited as fuck.
But you know what? It's so funny how, like, you justify things in your mind at that age, and you don't mm-hmm. think you're coming off that way, but you totally are.
Totally. I totally was. Like, I thought this was, like, okay to say that to people. It's like, no wonder why people with, like, good personalities didn't talk to me. I was garbage.
Yeah.
I acted like garbage.
Me too, man.
Okay, that was the short one.
Oh, God.
That was embarrassing.
That's terrifying.
Was, like, bearing my soul at 16.
Jesus, man. Here, can you... Wait, I'll just put this here. Ugh, because I have to pull up mine.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. I can't wait to hear this.
Ugh. I'm gonna die.
God, this is so long.
It's not that long. It just looks long because I have it in... The way it's spaced. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't even want to read the first sentence.
Here we go.
So let me start off by saying, my name is Megan. I'm probably one of the nicest people you'll ever meet, despite what you may think.
Oh my God.
Why on God's green earth would I ever say that?
I am nice to people, but, like, why do... I'm nice. It's fucking... Get it together, Megan. Basically, I'm only Let me try that again. Basically, I'm only mean if you give me a reason to be. I'd rather hug you than hurt you.
Wow.
What am I, a pacifist? That's
very bullet on my Valentine of you.
That's so, like, it's very, What happened here? What? My phone froze. Hold on.
Uh-oh.
Hold on. So sorry.
Is it okay?
Like, what the fuck was I thinking writing that? It's horrible. I know. I thought I was being like, oh, look at me, I'm approachable. But it's like, no, you sound fucking desperate. Yeah. I'm not tolerant of stupidity at all in any way. If you're going to annoy me with your ignorance and be an immature asshole, please do yourself a favor and refrain from talking to me.
Wow.
Wow.
We put ourselves on such giant pedestals at such a young age.
Like, I wasn't an immature asshole. Yeah. I was the most immature asshole.
I know.
Fucking give me a break.
Like, people owed us favors because you just happened to be talking to us. Like, give me a break.
Good lord. I will not tolerate it. Also, if you're a big-time pervert looking for someone to satisfy your sexual desires, I am not your girl. Me and Lauren had a lot of problems with older men
because we, like, developed very young,
like trying to get with us at a young age, so we had to be very frank about it. And I had a horrific incident happen to me like a year or two before this, so I was like doing everything in my power to not have it happen again. So I'm pretty sure that's why I wrote that. Horrible.
I know, but even still, when we put that shit out there, guys didn't fucking listen because they're gross.
Oh, God. I don't even... that's supposed to be or. I didn't understand this. Oh. I respect myself more than that. If you're not a pervert or a child, then I'll have no problems with you. Jesus Christ.
Oh, my God.
I don't think I'm going to read this whole thing. This is horrible.
You have to. Ugh.
As long as you could keep a conversation. I'm not a bitch in any way, shape, or form. That's a fucking lie. That is the biggest... load of horse shit.
You were bitchy the paragraph before you wrote that.
I can't say, like, don't talk to me if you're an asshole. I swear I'm not a bitch. No wonder why people fucking thought I was confusing.
Wow. Good we're bringing Lord. Down the psychology of our teenage selves on this episode.
The psychology of a Gemini. Totally, like, I'm not a bitch. Fuck you. You know?
Oh my gosh. That's, like, true Gemini, like.
God. That's horrible. Let's see. Where the fuck was I? Oh. And I'm really easy to talk to and get along with. I might seem intimidating at first, but really, no need to be scared. I promise.
It's intimidating, but you're yelling at people. Don't be a fucking asshole.
Like, yeah. Fucking Jesus Christ. Oh, okay. As far as interest goes, I'm big-time metalhead, and I'm in love with black and death metal. My current obsession being AINT.
Oh, yeah.
AINT. Do you remember that band?
Yeah.
They're pretty good still. I'll give them that. I absolutely despise this hardcore shit that you hear most kids listening to. It's absolutely repulsive.
Oh, like deathcore and
yeah,
shit?
Like, I meant deathcore, not hardcore. I still didn't know the difference at this age, I don't think.
Hardcore is very different.
Because I love, like, old-school hardcore, like, from, like, Boston hardcore and shit like that.
Yeah.
Did not know there was a difference. I'm talking about deathcore. Oh, yeah, because I said this. It's absolutely repulsive. If you ask me if I listened to the Black Dahlia murder, you obviously didn't take the time to read my profile, and I'll just end up ignoring you.
Oh, my God.
That is so cunty of me. Holy fuck.
And to be fair, Black Dahlia murder puts on a fucking good show.
I don't like them. I still fucking detest them with every fiber in my being. But, like, why did I have to say that?
I know.
Horrible. But you know why? It's because I got approached by a lot of dudes that were like, oh, you fucking listen to Whitechapel? Fucking bullshit. And it's like, ugh, it was so annoying.
So, like, we understand where this is coming from, but at the same time, we did not execute this well.
That was not very well written.
No.
Other things I like are horror movies, mainly creature features and the classics, zombies in the 20s and 50s eras, medical TV shows, and going to shows. I still like all those things.
Yeah, you still love all that shit.
I like all of these things.
Yeah.
The 20s and the 50s. Very specific, but very true.
Well, no, it is true, because you have a lot of stuff from the 20s and 50s.
I do.
Literally, like, dolls and, like, old, like pictures and, like, shit like that. Like, you have a ton of stuff from that era.
Yes, I do. Hold on, I'm getting hot. I'm like,
you have to remove your shawl.
My shawl.
I'm an old lady.
Oh, God.
I'm having a hot flash.
This fucking sucks. Well, that part wasn't too bad. That's still true.
Yeah.
There's so much more I could list, so if you want to know more, chat with me sometime.
Ugh.
I do have a few important idols that I absolutely adore as well. Oh, no. Don't make me read these.
Oh, no.
No. Why would I say this? She's not an idol to me. Well, Vincent Price, yes. Elizabeth Bathory.
Jesus Christ.
Who doesn't love a fucking murderous fucking tyrant, you know? Jeffrey Dahmer.
Why?
Jeffrey Dahmer is not
I feel like half the shit we said was just to make herself seem cool.
For the record, these are people that I found interesting. I did not idolize them.
Yeah.
I will say that. That is what I meant by this. I do not adore them. Well, I adore Vincent Price. And Rasputin.
What the fuck?
Ted Bundy. Lucille Ball and Hitler.
I mean, you couldn't ask for a more random group of people.
God, people thought I was probably crazy because it's like, oh, I love Lucille Ball, but also Hitler. I found him interesting. I love Lucille Ball, though.
Yeah.
I think she's great. Oh, and I follow with, no, I am not a Nazi. I admire Hitler for what kind of person he was, not what he believed in.
What the fuck does that mean?
That's the same fucking thing, you dunce. But yeah, enough with that bullshit. Yeah, it is bullshit, Megan. If you actually took the time to read that, then that makes me happy and I'd like to talk to you. Is this like for a dating website? I swear to God. Well, VF kind of was like a dating website.
Yeah, my last ex that I met him through Vampire Freaks.
And again, I know. I met, like, a lot of my friends through there, too, that I'm still friends with today.
I know.
Surprisingly.
One of my best friends, my friend Rachel, I met on Vampire Freaks.
I love you, Rach Bear.
Oh, my God. I hope she listens to this. I'll be so happy.
Rachel, I hope you listen. Please, listen to us.
If not, I'm just going to send you this episode and be like, I shouted you out!
Again, I iterate. I promise I don't bite.
I mean...
If you want to get in touch outside this website, talk to me and ask me for my screen name or whatever. Oh, that's right, because I was 16, so it's probably
AIM.
Like AIM or MSN or something.
Ooh, my ears popped. Sorry.
Oh, God. But remember, I'll only give out any of those things if you talk to me first. Ask me firsthand, expect no reply. What the fuck? And do not ask me for MSN, I no longer have it. What the fuck was about?
It's like people owed us. It's like, you found me? Oh, good. Now you have to do this for me. Like, Jesus Christ.
What the fuck, dude?
I'm going to read my 20-year-old profile. Like, when I was 20 years old, I wrote this profile. Are you ready? This is a fucking novel. By paragraph 2, I would have checked out of this.
Are you sure you want to read all this? We don't want to bore people either. Not that to say that this is boring, but like...
I'm not going to read the whole thing.
Yeah, I would say skim it because
It's so long and so boring. I'm like, Jesus Christ. I'm just going to skim it and point out like key things that I said as a 20-year-old. This is 6 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So like this decade this happened. First of all, this is on my Vampire Freaks profile. You could literally go to my profile and read this whole thing. So that's probably why I won't read it all either. I'll link my VF in the fucking description of this podcast. If you want to go read how much of a fucking dickhead I was back then.
I haven't used mine in years, so if you go to mine, you won't find anything interesting. There's nothing on there.
Megan's is linked on my page. You could go there, I believe.
Oh, is it?
If it wants to load.
Hello?
Oh, no. Oh my God, what happened? I'm using their fucking app. It's garbage.
Yeah.
It's made for like the iPhone 4. Like, literally.
Lauren.
I think you're on my profile though, anyways. Hold on, let me scroll down and see.
Oh God.
I mean, look how long this is.
Lauren, this is like the Odyssey wasn't this long.
Jesus Christ. Oh yeah. Megan is the first person in my friends list.
You will see it. It looks like me. Look, there's, like, a picture and, like, that, and, like, my favorite things in music.
Oh, yeah, you don't really have a profile on there.
I don't really have mine.
Okay, so, I still have, like, my full profile.
Oh, your screen name.
I know, my screen name is Lauren Lunatic.
Help.
Because I made this back when that was a fucking thing. Because that was like a MySpace thing. It was like your first name and then like
a word that
like some adjective that's like rhymes with your name, like some kind of like alliteration, you know?
Yeah, because for mine for the longest time, because someone called me this, I don't know, in like some metal forum or something, because we talked about Mayhem, so I was Megan Mayhem.
Yeah,
for a long time.
Mine's Lauren Lunatic.
Yeah,
you know, like you get the alliteration. So here we go. This is some of my profile that you could literally go and read right now. Me at 20 years old.
Time capsule.
I assume you came to my profile for one of two reasons. You're either generally interested in getting to know me, or you're just here for the tits. I mean, which is true, but did I have to put it like that? No, I didn't have to do that.
I mean,
if the second one happens to be your reason, just know I probably won't comment back.
Good lord.
I mean, how much of a fucking ego did I have that I had to say that to
people? Oh, you're probably here, but to be fair, you and I got a lot of unwanted attention.
Yeah, then I follow up, but generally, I always return comments, but I don't associate myself with perverts. I'm in the land of perverts. It's like going to the fucking grocery store and be like, yeah, I don't like food. It's like, you're in the grocery store. Jesus Christ.
I'm so sorry.
And then, like, I give full details about my life, what I was doing in college and fucking all this shit. I was going for business, and I really wanted to own, like, a merch store to sell band shit, like a fucking label. I'm like, first of all, I would never do that.
Second of all, my buddy Tim, who I've shouted out in here before, of Diabolic Force Distribution, can't fucking talk, he will tell you, do not do that.
Yeah.
Because he's looking to sell everything.
This was 6 years ago, so I don't know how different it was back then.
Well, but I mean, not much different.
Yeah, I just say I'm passionate about music metal. It's my favorite, of course, death, black, melodic death, thrash, power, folk, doom, grindcore. Like, I really needed to, like, list off every subgenre of metal.
Yeah, just
exists.
Say metal.
It's all the same, almost.
Not really, no. But I get you.
I don't limit myself to just metal. I'm also a big fan of jazz and classical. No, I'm also a fan of K-pop, fucking pop, like, other, like, 90s pop music. I love everything.
Same.
So, I like shitty music as long as good music.
Yes.
Like, shitty as in, like, you know, why would you ever listen? Like, Eiffel 65. You know what I mean?
Sorry, please continue.
I put big fan of jazz and classical. Yeah, like the old school classical music where, you know, music was actually composed and not just thrown together like most of the mainstream shit on the radio today. It's all composed.
Yeah.
What was I thinking? I think I meant to say it was like used with like orchestral instruments and not just a fucking computer.
Yeah.
Like, my dumbass.
Oh, Lauren.
Oh, yeah, here we go. I've been told that I just listen to certain bands to get dick and gain attention, when really, I actually listen to the music and actually like the bands I listen to. Like, well, why did I have to justify that?
Well, because, to be fair, you and I have been attacked before. Like, are you really a fan of this?
I mean, that's true, but I didn't have to put that on my profile.
Yeah,
it's I would have just told the person, like, you're a fucking dickhead.
Yeah, because Laura and I, like, oh, but do you actually like this? It's like, fuck you. Maybe I do.
Yeah. If anyone has a problem with my music choices, tell it to my ass, because I know what I like and nothing anyone says will change my opinions about my music.
Tell it
to my ass. To be fair, my ass probably has its own fucking orbit. It's so monstrous. Jesus Christ. And I'm not saying, like, it's not like Kim Kardashian big, but I mean, it's big. We're Italian.
Yeah. You know.
Italians got big butts.
Big butts. Yep.
Like, it's a butt that's Sir Mix-a-Lot with a joy.
Yeah.
Jesus. That's a quarter off that ass.
Oh my god.
I don't know what's wrong with me today. I'm really sorry.
I need bed rest.
Let's see. Aside from being a music junkie, I'm also a gigantic dork. No, I'm not the kind of dork where I pretend to be socially awkward or wear Buddy Holly glasses and mismatched socks. Okay, first of all, that is, like, really annoying.
Yeah.
Like, hot chicks in, like, these big old glasses. Like, oh, I'm such a dork. Like, bitch, get over yourself.
You bitch, put on- I'm blind.
Yeah. Okay? Like, you put on fucking Buddy Holly glasses just to be cute.
Yeah.
Like, you're not a dork. You don't fucking stay up till 3 a.m. reading about the Great Depression because you can't go to sleep.
Yeah. So,
which I've done many times, and the Great Depression scares the shit out of me.
Do you read about the Great Depression?
Yeah.
Lord, that is the worst thing you could do before going to bed. Because
I'm like, oh, this will bore me to sleep. No, I'm sitting there wide awake, wired as shit.
No, read, like- read, what the fuck is it called? Karl Marx's book about capitalism.
I had to read that before. It was fucking awful.
Dude, you want to talk about a fucking snooze fest. I couldn't get through it.
I had to do a report on that.
Me too. And it's like, I remember sitting there and I literally, my face hit the book more than my eyes did.
Yeah.
Just like, you know?
You ever like have your phone, like you're in your bed and you're on your phone and you're like falling asleep and it just falls on your fucking face?
God,
it jolts you awake.
We have these giant ass phones and it hurts when they fall. It's like a brick to the face. It hurts. Sorry, continue.
I love to read anything I can get my hands on, blah, blah, blah. Yes.
Well, that hasn't changed.
No, it hasn't. I still love doing that. I also watch a lot of History, Discovery Channel, and Travel Channel. It's much more entertaining to me than fucking reality shows. That's still true, but I don't really watch TV anymore.
I know.
I just keep on AMC because I like looking at movies in the background.
Yeah.
They've been playing Jaws on there for like 3 weeks.
No, like 3 weeks. Like,
what is happening? Like, there was a Walking Dead marathon, and then every time I turn it on, it's just Jaws.
I know.
Jaws 1 to, you know, 75, or however many they made. Yeah. They played all of them.
All the Jawses.
I love to write, blah, blah, blah. I love how people claim to be a writer after only writing one or two pieces of writing, and both of them are about getting dumped. Like, that's so demeaning to other people.
Yeah.
You know what? Their one or two pieces are probably better than any fucking piece of shit I ever wrote.
Lauren.
Well,
don't put yourself down either.
Well, in this context, I'm going to put myself down a little bit.
Okay.
But I'm just saying, everyone should write.
Yes.
Or at least try to. Even if you don't like writing.
Just write down your thoughts.
It's like, people think it's like stupid to like have a journal or like a diary or whatever. I think it's like the best thing you could do for yourself.
Yeah.
Because if no one else will listen, at least you could write it down and get it out into the world.
Or even just like type it in your notes on your phone.
Yeah.
It just makes you feel better to just get your words out.
But
don't
post it to Facebook, please, because
we don't
that's
care.
Not a place to bury your soul.
Yeah.
You know, just keep that shit, you know.
And private. You just contradicted yourself again. Because you're like, everyone should write, but don't share it with everyone.
Well, I mean, like, journal-wise.
No, oh, okay.
But, like, actual, like, poems or, like, stories, you should fucking share that shit.
Yeah. Please, you know? Share your shit.
Even if it's not that great, do it anyway.
I know, but I know what you're talking about. Like, the people that air out their dirty laundry.
Yeah, they go into, like, full, like, there's a couple people on my Facebook friends list who just, it's, like, every minute detail of their life they share.
I took a shit this morning. It was brown. It's like, fucking, yeah, lady.
I've been having gas problems for, like, the last 3 days, and I finally shit, and it was so great. I'm like, fucking, who cares?
I know.
But, couple more things.
Oh, God.
But in general, I'm a very nice person. Why do we have to, like, you know, put that as, like, a disclaimer? It's like, I know I said a lot of this shit, and I seem really bitchy, but I'm actually super nice.
Yeah. Like,
it's like, clearly I wasn't. Why do I justify that I'm nice?
Yeah.
You would know if I was a nice person just by talking to me.
Yeah, nice people don't tell other people, fuck you.
Yeah.
Just saying.
I know. Oh, no. Then I contradict myself. I'm nice to about 99% of the people I talk to. The only time I'll ever yell or argue with someone is if I'm provoked first or if that person really did something fucked up to me. Well, I mean, that's true, but, like,
I mean, I kind of get what you're saying,
but I said that awfully.
Yeah, that was not well put.
Otherwise, I'm not really a fighter. No, I fight. I don't know what I was thinking when I wrote that shit. I will fight. I'm a huge traveler, blah, blah, blah. I suppose that's enough for... I'll just read the last paragraph. I suppose that's enough for now.
You think?
If you want to know something else about me, just send me a message, and I'll reply back. But if you've been staring at my tits the whole time and managed to catch this sentence in my little about me section, this is not little.
It's not little at
you
all.
You could just go now. Yep. And then I put a smiley face. What the fuck?
Lauren.
What? This was not little. This was like a novel and a half. And then I have, on Vampire Freaks, you could put likes and dislikes. And I put, like, my likes, but then I had to put a paragraph underneath each like to explain why I like it. As if anyone gives a fuck.
God.
And same with my the stuff that I loathe. I'm like... And then I have a whole list of bands. I read through it. Don't even listen to half of them. I'm like, why did I put all this shit? Oh my god, this is such a mess.
Lauren so, angrily, like, closed her phone.
I'm gonna link my VF profile. Just go fucking read it for yourself. You'll see what I'm talking about. It's literally, it'll take you 20 minutes to get through my profile.
I was gonna say, if you have 3 hours to kill, you know
why no one talked to me? There was too much shit on there.
Yeah.
Like, get to the point.
Well, Gemini's also, you know.
I know. We're
wordy.
We're big talkers, as you could tell.
Yes.
But, Jesus Christ. Like,
I mean, that's
excessive.
I did not
need to put that much shit on my profile.
It's a little excessive.
Yeah.
Well, that was fun.
Just
for it. You look like you just went through hell and back.
I don't know why I thought this was a good idea. I, like, regret everything now.
Oh, God. I know. I'm reading it and I'm like, God, I was cunty.
I know, but it's so crazy how, like, literally, as I'm sitting there reading through both of our shit, you know, how we perceived stuff back then to be okay, but, like, now we look at it as adults and we're like, this is not okay.
Well, you know, this is what I said too, and I think I don't know if I said this to you or to someone else, but it's like, because we didn't have anyone in our lives telling us that this was not okay, or like, you shouldn't say that. We didn't have anyone that gave that much of a shit to tell us, like, no,
which is sad.
Talk like that. Yeah, which is sad, but now I do, so.
Yeah,
you know,
that's true.
Had to learn it myself, like, oh, I probably shouldn't say that because it's off-putting.
Yeah.
You know, and telling people, I'm nice, but fuck you. It's like, yeah, that's a little off-putting and confusing.
I know.
But, yeah, so that was fun.
Christ.
Now I feel bad about myself. No, I don't. I actually, if anything, I feel better about myself now because I'm not like that anymore.
Honestly, that's the confidence boost I needed because I'm like, wow, I'm not that shitty anymore.
Yeah.
Like, I can't believe I'm like... Like, you and I had the nerve to, like, tell people, oh, if you're a fucking pervert, don't even talk to me, but otherwise hit me up. Like,
dude, I went right for the jugular with people's intelligence. I'm like, if you're fucking stupid, don't talk to me.
I know.
It's like, whoa,
it's
Megan.
Like, how do you gauge intelligence on someone without ever even talking to them?
When someone uses your in the wrong context.
That's true.
I
spell
hated...
your, you are, like, as one word.
I could not talk to anyone that used the wrong your.
I know.
At that point in my life.
But you know what?
I couldn't.
Here's a pet peeve, too. And we're going to do an episode on pet peeves one day.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I know I've said this a couple times, but I literally
have a
list. The pet peeve of mine, though, is like when someone like makes a spelling mistake and you correct them and then they get fucking mad at you. Like, oh, look at you all fucking uptight in grammar. I'm like, I'm pointing out your mistake.
Yeah.
So you don't do it again.
I'm
doing you a favor.
It's like, it's just, I'm trying to be helpful, you know? Fuck, man.
It's like, if you don't want people to, you know, make fun of you, maybe just learn how to spell your right.
Do you know how easy it is to Google what the right your is?
I know.
It takes 3 seconds.
And there, also.
And there.
Because there's, like, so many iterations of, like, there. It's like, they are, and then there, as in over there.
The worst one, though, is your welcome with Y-O-U-R.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm just like, my welcome what, asshole?
Yeah.
Like, what's my welcome? Like, it's just, that's the one that makes me the most infurious.
I know. I hate that. Did you say infurious?
Infuriated is what I meant to say. I know, I just took
I love how we paused to take that in for
a second.
Infurious?
Oh, yeah. Don't talk to me if you're stupid. I'm infurious.
Fucking give me a break.
Well.
It's amazing how much of an ego you have when you have people in your life who are, like, terrible people, and
they constantly stroke your ego, but it should not be stroked like that.
No.
It's horrible.
That's why having, like, now a lot of, like, kids today who are teenagers have, like, huge platforms and millions of dollars.
Yeah.
And it's, like...
And attitude problems. And no respect for authority or empathy.
Oh, yeah. That's why they should be well into their 20s before they ever have any kind of power like that.
The human brain doesn't fully develop until 24.
Yeah.
Why are we giving a fucking 13-year-old that much freedom?
I know.
Could you imagine, think about how we were at this age, like 16. What if we had a platform like fucking Instagram or something?
Or YouTube.
Or YouTube.
Or like we had some kind of talent and we were on a TV show and like we had a big following and millions of dollars. Imagine how much that goes to the fucking brain.
Ugh, I couldn't even, I would be the worst human. I would have nobody. Oh my God. I would be horrible.
I'm glad
that's
that
why
happen.
These kids are horrible, because they're kids and you're treating them like adults when they shouldn't be treated like adults.
I know.
It's horrible.
I know. And, but, you know, not every child is like that. Some children, you know,
some children graduate college at 13.
Yeah.
You know?
It's one thing. But it's like,
for the most part, like the people that we glorify now is what I'm specifically talking
about. The Justin
Biebers
of the world.
Yeah. And the, what the fuck is her name? Danielle Bergioli or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Danielle Bergioli.
Yeah. The Cash Me Outside girl or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
And people put her in a fucking pedestal because she was some fucking bitch with an attitude problem on Dr. Phil.
Yeah. But apparently, I forgot who was talking about this a while ago, but I heard, like, a lot of Dr. Phil is, like, fake. Like, Maury and, like, yeah, you know, Jerry Springer and stuff. Like, it's all, like, glorified. So she probably, like, over-glorified herself and then made a career out of it.
It's
so
horrible.
She could be just a character at fucking 13.
And then you watch how the mom treats her, and her mom is just egging it on.
Yeah.
She's not fixing the problem. She just thinks it's totally fine. As long as I'm on TV and you can pay my bills, like, they don't give a shit. It's disgusting how people are.
I know.
So I'm glad we're not like that anymore.
No.
Because, God, I understand why my mom and I argued so much. I thought I was so fucking cool and I knew everything and fucking, you know, everybody says that. Oh, you think you're so cool. It's like, I really thought I was great.
Yeah. Like, we really thought at 14, 15, we had our lives figured out.
Yeah.
I can't even tell you how much my life has changed in the last 10 years.
Same. Honestly.
So, you don't have your life figured out at fucking 14, 15.
I know.
Even 16. I'm kind of made those profiles.
I know. I'm kind of happy we saved these, though, so we could look back and be like, wow.
I know.
How much we actually changed. Because had I read this 2 years after I posted that, I would have been like, oh, this is funny. Like, it's cool.
Yeah.
And I would have probably still thought the same things. But even, like, at 20, I'm sitting
there. I
know.
20 years old. I was probably about to be 21. And fucking, I wrote that shit.
Yeah.
I mean, it's ridiculous. I haven't really used Vampire Freak since then, but
me either. Oh God, I'm sorry.
I updated it with pictures and stuff, like, over time,
mm-hmm,
like a little bit, but otherwise I haven't posted anything on there in like 3 years.
Me either.
Like a picture or anything. I haven't replied to anyone, haven't. But it was funny because as I was going through my profile and I was online, someone literally sent me a message saying I was hot.
That's hilarious.
I'm like, even like the thirst is real, like 10 years later.
Yeah.
Like, it hasn't stopped. And it's like, it's always like people from France. Always dudes from France. I'm like, don't you sleep? It's like,
no.
I feel like I
they're
always
on the quest for pussy. There's no time to sleep.
Well, I know. They like that, you know. French pussy.
That French pussy, though.
I was going to say French baguette, but I'm like, that's a better reference for a dick.
Yeah. That escargot.
That makes sense.
Ew.
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 Here, like, let me see if I even, like, no, I didn't get anything in the time I was on here.
Thank God. I know I always get, like, messages from, like, dudes in Romania, or I used to, I should say.
Yeah.
Like, oh, greeting.
Oh, yeah, like, weird places
like
that.
Greetings from Romania. It's like, who are you? Jesus.
I know, they always say greetings.
Greetings. It's like,
are you going to suck my blood?
Yeah.
Like, I don't understand.
Please, I don't want to die. I have too much left to do.
So, I'm afraid to talk to anyone from that area. Because, like, I'm like, they're going to fucking, you know, charm my pants off, and then I'm going to end up in a castle and with, like, teeth marks in my neck.
Yeah.
Like, could you imagine if, like, actual vampires were on Vampire Freaks? And it was, like, an actual, like, vampire website, and we just had no idea.
Oh my God. That would be great.
And, like, we got lured in by, like, a dude from, like, you know, Romania or, like, Transylvania or whatever.
Fucking goddamn.
And just, like, we end up at, like, a fucking castle. Just with teeth marks and, like, I can't think about that.
Oh God. Well, this has been fun.
My eyes hurt from laughing so fucking hard at you.
I'm sorry. I know. You're still thinking about sun salutations?
Yeah.
Jesus. I know. I'm going to be getting texts for the next 3 days of sun salutations.
It's just different people doing them.
Yeah.
Be like fucking Cookie Monster doing a sun salutation.
Could you imagine just like that Muppet quality?
I would die if I found...
Oh my God.
Like, I'm gonna Google it later and see if, like, I find a picture of Cookie Monster doing a sun salutation.
Okay.
I will literally...
If you actually find that, send it to me.
I Google will piss my pants laughing if I find it.
Google is incredible.
I know.
Like,
some of the shit we find on Google...
The only thing I've never been able to find on Google is, like, different, like, classical songs that I like.
Yeah.
Because you can't Google, like, the part that goes... Da-da-da-da-da, like, the...
Yeah, that one part with the flute.
Yeah. Like, you can't Google that.
I know.
It's like... But that's why I love Shazam, too. Because it's like, you just hold that shit up and it's like, oh, yeah, this is Overture and blah, blah, blah. And you're like, cool.
I know.
Thanks, Shazam.
Shazam is great. I'm like, how do you fucking know this?
Yeah.
And then Shazam has this thing, though, like, every time you, like, Shazam someone, you follow that artist on there. So, like, I can't even tell you the amount of random people that I just follow on Shazam.
Does Mozart have a Shazam?
I don't know. I have to Shazam a song and I'll sing.
Okay. Because if Mozart has a social media profile, even though he's been dead for hundreds of years...
That's going to be incredible.
That's going to be great. He's the best-selling artist of all time. He's still putting out records.
Yeah. Oh, God. All right.
Well, speaking of music, what do you got this week?
Well, since we're talking about our angsty selves, let's put in some angsty music.
Oh, God.
I was listening to Marilyn Manson the other day.
Oh, thank goodness. I thought you were going to say Bullet for My Valentine or something.
Oh, my God. Could you imagine? I was like, yeah, here's Tears Don't Fall.
Ugh.
Oh, my gosh.
Blah. Blah.
Megan hates it.
I... Can't
Sometimes
even listen to
I have
it.
A good shower session where I'm just screaming those lyrics, punching the wall,
crying.
Yeah, you can't tell because I'm wet, but I'm crying in there. My eyes are all red.
Oh
but,
my God.
So
some Manson.
Yeah, I really loved the Golden Age of Grotesque album.
Oh, me too.
That came out how many fucking years ago?
Like 74.
Put in one of the songs from there. Haven't really figured out which one yet.
One
Maybe
of them.
Saint.
Oh, I do love
or
that song.
Or maybe this is the new shit. One of those.
Okay. Oh, I love that album.
I know.
I really, you know what? I'm a big Marilyn Manson fan.
I know. We've always loved Marilyn Manson.
I just, because he's so different from, like, other people.
Yeah.
Again, going back to, Laura and I like very niche things and people that are very much, like, their own self.
Yeah.
So, no one, people have tried to replicate him, but
no
can't.
One is Marilyn Manson.
No one is him. So...
He's always kept true to himself and his own style.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Especially at a young age.
Yes.
You know? It's inspiring. But...
The we God actually of did angst.
I know. We actually did get to see him at Mayhem Fest when he was fat and, like, had, like, a dad gut.
Oh, dude, it was great.
And confetti fell from the ceiling and we all fucking freaked out.
I swallowed it.
I know, you did.
I was so drunk that I swallowed the confetti.
Because
I was, like... I was singing and I was like...
It was so
bad.
Me and, like, oh my God, we were there with a group of our guy friends from Windsor, mm-hmm. and I think it was Chris and I were, like, crying laughing because you fucking swallowed paper.
I was dying. I'm like, I need water.
Blech. We didn't have water. We had beer. You're like, fuck it.
It was like imagine a Listerine pack, but, like, four times the size.
Yeah,
that's what I swallowed.
Ew.
Ew. It was gross.
Oh my God, you could have choked.
I know.
We were not safe in that pit.
We were not, like, mindful at all as kids.
I know.
So bad.
That was a concert where the dude gave us the beer and it had something in it.
Oh, yeah, that was the time.
Yeah, we were watching Marilyn Manson, like, on some kind of shit, just like...
I don't know what it was, but it made me feel weird and I swallowed paper.
Mm-hmm. So. It's the only time that ever happened.
Yeah.
So...
Ugh.
Now we know better not to take drinks from a stranger.
Yep. But, so anyway, here.
So we're going to put in Marilyn Manson.
We're going to put in the God of Angst.
We're going to go cool down because I'm so fucking hot.
I know.
Even I'm cold. Is the fan on you or is it on me? It's on me too.
Oh, okay.
But I'm still hot because I was laughing so hard.
Oh, God. I know when you laugh too hard, you start sweating.
I know. I told you. I'm so warm blood. It's going to take me 2 hours to cool down.
Well, just sit in front of the fan. I'm cold. I know, sorry.
No, it's cool.
I don't want my room to overheat.
Well, I know.
Because we're both in here.
Yes.
You know. Just making it hotter by existing. Yeah. Our existence just makes the room hotter.
Yeah. But, all right.
I'm going to put that shit in. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode.
Hope you enjoyed this
very giggly and nostalgic. And
yeah. Just us laughing at ourselves yet again. But, yep.
You know, it's like, let us know if you have anything like that or if you've done any self-improving lately or shit like that.
Yeah, talk to us.
Talk to us. We would love to hear from you. We don't really get a lot of messages.
I know.
Please.
We get some, but not a lot.
Yeah. But, like, talk to me. We want to hear what you have to say.
Please.
Please.
All right.
See you next week, everyone. Right. I don't know what we're going to do, but...
I don't know either. Maybe we'll do the pet peeves next week, because we keep talking about it.
We'll do the thing we were going to do this week next week.
Oh, yes. That thing. So,
the thing.
Yeah.
But, all right, everyone. We'll see you next week.
Yep, see you next week, everyone.
All right, bye.
Bye. I don't care if you're